Hi guys, this is the second tutorial of this series, and in this tutorial I am going to show you how you can set up a code block and how you can run a code in code block. So in the last tutorial you must have downloaded the code blocks and installed it, and I have just created a shortcut of the code blocks on my desktop. So I'm gonna open it. So in the last tutorial you have downloaded it and you must have installed it, because in this tutorial we are gonna need a code block. So we are going to open it. So we have opened the code blocks. So in this code block we have to create a project. So we are getting an option to create a project here also, and we can also create a project by going in new and in project also. So we are going to click on that, and after that we are going to get a bunch of options. So in those we have to just select console application and go. Okay, then they will ask you for the little welcome note. After that you have to do next, and in this means we are working on C language, so we are going to select C. If you are working with CPP, then you can also click on it CPP and go next, but in this tutorial we are working on C, so we are going to click on that and do the next. Okay, and then we have to put a project title. So I'm gonna put my project title like C Superdose. So and I'm going to select it in okay. So I have selected the path, then next, then they will automatically fill the remaining spaces. Because these settings are by default, you don't have to do the changes in those. So then click on finish, and we have set up the code block. Now what we have to do is we have given our project name, that's ctutors, and in the source file we are going to get a main.c. So what is this main.c is? It's a source file, and when you click on that you will get a code in C. So at this time you don't know about this code, I know, so but I will show you that how you can run this code, and in the coming tutorials I will explain you this code later. Okay, so here is the option build and run. So basically what build and run do is it converts this code into the language, into the language which computer can understand. So it will convert it, build it, and after it will run it. Okay, so if you want to build it first, then you can click on this, and after you can run it. But this button will do for you is that it will automatically build it and run it for you. So we are going to click on it. So it's running, and the code is running successfully. Okay, so hello world is printing on the screen. So the printf is given that hello world should be printed on the screen. So in this way you can execute your C code in code blocks. So in the coming tutorial I will show you that how you can how you can understand this code. Okay, so until then, thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel.